Good morning, children. Today I am going to take the first chapter of your English reader, The Evergreen. This is a story of a little bird who was very proud of her beautiful wings. Now I will read the chapter and give you the paragraph wise explanation of the chapter. A pretty bird sat on the branch of a tree. She loved her wings. The proud bird began to laugh loudly at a plain little mouse that passed by. So in this paragraph, we came to know that a pretty bird was sitting on the branch of a tree. She was very proud of her beautiful wings. And the arrogant bird began to laugh at a simple little mouse who passed by. "Whom are you laughing at?" asked the mouse. When mouse saw the bird laughing, he asked the bird that at whom she is laughing. "At you, you ugly thing. See my lovely wings." Now that bird replied that she was laughing at that ugly looking mouse. Again she started boasting about her beautiful and lovely wings. She said, flapping her wings. She flew high up in the clouds. Now she started flapping her wings and she flew high up in the clouds. She flew high up in the clouds, then came down gracefully to glide over the housetop. Now she flapped her wings, flew high up in the clouds, and she came down elegantly to skate or to glide over a housetop. Suddenly, she dashed against a chimney and broke her wing. She could no longer fly and had to hop home. So when she was coming, she was gliding down at the housetop. She could not properly land and suddenly she was hit hard or she was dashed against the chimney and broke her wing. Now she could not fly and she had to hop home. Winter came. All other birds flew away to warmer places. But the bird with the broken wing hopped from tree to tree for shelter. So when the winter season came, all the birds flew to the warmer places, but the bird who had broken her wings was not able to fly, so she went to all the trees one by one to provide her shelter. She asked the oak tree, "Please, may I stay in your branches till spring comes? I have a broken wing." So she went to the oak tree and asked him, please, may I stay in your branches till the spring season comes. Now, how oak tree? "Out you go," shouted oak. "I cannot allow birds to live here." So, oak tree shouted on her and said that it will not allow her to stay there as it is. He will not allow the strange people or strange birds to live in its branches. Then she went to the willow tree to refuse to let her stay. "I shall die of cold," said the little bird sadly. The little mouse at whom she had laughed was watching her. "God always punishes the proud," he said as he moved away. So the little bird went to the oak tree. That oak tree also refused to help her. Then she went to the willow tree for help. Willow tree also refused to help her. The bird begged to the willow tree, "Please, please allow me to stay here as it is very cold and she will die of cold." The mouse at whom the bird had laughed earlier was watching her and he said, "God always punish the arrogant people." Now, the little bird was now ashamed and sorry for being so proud and rude. She heard a voice from the forest saying, "Little bird, I forgive you. Find a pine tree. It will help you." So the bird was very ashamed and felt sorry for her being so rude to the little mouse. And she heard a voice from the forest saying that you go to the pine tree and that pine tree will help you out. The bird hopped and hopped till she found a pine tree. She told the pine her story. So the little bird went in search of a pine tree. At last she found the pine tree and told the whole story to the tree. "Don't worry, just hop into my branches and rest," said the kind tree. So the pine tree was very kind to her, to the bird, and it allowed the bird to stay in its branches. The fir tree, who stood nearby, whispered, "I'll shelter you from icy winds." And the juniper called out, "Come, eat my berries when you are hungry." So when she, the pine tree was agreed to, pine tree agreed to help the little bird, and he was very kind to the bird. And the fir tree, who stood nearby, also agreed to shelter her from the icy winds. Icy winds means here the cold winds which will blow, will that fir tree will protect the bird from the icy winds. And the juniper tree also allowed the bird to have its berries whenever the bird is feeling hungry. Now next day, King Winter told the North Wind, as it shook the leaves of trees, "Let the pine, fir and the juniper tree keep their dresses of green." They were kind to the little bird. Now next day, the King Winter told the North Wind that the pine, the juniper and the fir tree to have their green dresses throughout the year, as they were very kind to the little bird. That is, these trees will remain green throughout the year as they were very kind to the little bird. That is why the pine, the fir, the juniper are called the evergreens, and they are the most popular trees at the Christmas tree, Christmas time too. So now that is the reason why these three trees are called evergreen trees, because they are very kind to the bird. So the King Winter had allowed them to have the green dresses throughout the year. So now children, this is the story of a little bird. So I hope you must have understood. Now I will get back with you with the exercise of this chapter. Thank you.